What is going on, nerds and nerdettes? It's your boy, Stevie B. Before we jump into this week's Mystery Box Unboxing, quick announcement. Honestly, I've done a little soul searching about my channel. When I hit 1,000 subscribers, I started to get excited thinking about the monetization. I'm not going to lie. I thought about I can make a little few extra bucks to help pay for the channel. And then what happened was that the channel started becoming a grind. And I started stressing more about subscribers and the numbers and all this. And I come to the realization that when I started this YouTube channel, it had nothing to do with money. I never thought in a million years that I would ever make money from this channel. I did this for fun. I did it because I enjoy comics. I enjoy talking about comics. And somewhere along the way, I kind of lost sight of that and started thinking about, the analytics and all this and stuff. And so I've come to the conclusion that I'm not going to worry about the analytics. Don't care if I monetize my channel anymore. This is definitely not a pity party. This is a revelation. This is a good thing for me. I want to go back to what was fun about this channel. The editing part, playing whatever the hell kind of music I want to play on my channel. Not worrying about copyright strikes. So, that being said, this starts a new chapter in Stevie B Comics. I hope you all enjoy it. I would appreciate your feedback. Tell me what you hate. Tell me what you like. Feedback on me, because I'm doing this. I want to entertain you. I want you to enjoy what you watch. But that being said, let's kick off chapter one in the new book of Stevie B Comics. And what better way to start it off than with some Doghouse comics? So let's get right into it. What is going on, nerds and nerdettes? It's your boy, Stevie B, with another Mystery Box unboxing for you. Today, we are back to an old faithful, I like to call him, and that is Matt Idell over at Doghouse Comics. Now, he recently did a show on Comic Foo 2814's channel. I had OCD about stuff, tape. Stick it up, gotta peel it off. But he was on Comic Foo 2814's channel on the Building a Mystery show, pimping out his latest iteration of his mystery boxes. I did not watch the show, perfectly honest with you. I'm not a fan of watching shows about mystery boxes that I intend to buy anyway, because I don't want to know. I mean, if it comes from somebody that I have complete faith in, like Matt, then, I don't want spoilers, so I didn't get any spoilers. But he does ship Priority, and he had to step out of town, little family emergency, so these are about a week later than expected, but that's okay. He sent a message in Instagram saying, hey, for those of you that bought the box already, I have to go out of town, family emergency. let me know what kind of books you're into, what you like, and I'll throw in some extras for you for the inconvenience. I didn't send him anything because, you know, Matt's a good dude, and family emergency is a family emergency. Take care of your family. Don't worry about whether I get an extra comic book or not in my mystery box. I'm perfectly content with the box that I got, and no need to apologize or make it up to me. So that being said, I didn't respond to it. Matt, I wasn't ignoring you. I'm just like, dude, you take care of family. The last thing you need to worry about is these mystery boxes right now. So I didn't want to burden you with worrying about that. I wanted you to go take care of your business. But anyway, I'm excited anyway. So, like I said, I have no idea what to expect from these other than they come from Doghouse Comics. So I have no doubt in my mind that it's a great box. And all right, come shift. Packing peanuts, Matt. You were on Foo's channel and called Building a Mystery, and Foo did not tell you the hell that is packing peanuts. Oh, man. Of course, Foo puts Foo-fetti in his. So, anyway, nicely bubble wrapped here. There's a... yeah. Two envelopes. There's a little priority envelope here as well. Not sure what that's about, but it's stuck in there with this, which I'm guessing is the core box. So I'll open that other priority envelope last, and we'll go with there. But anyway, securely fast in a Gemini mailer, about 400 layers of tape holding it in. And then his patented purple bag. So I'm excited. Really am. I've never gotten a bad box from Matt. Even the ones that I buy from, you know, on a regular basis, even from the man himself, Comic Vantage, I've had a few boxes, you know, that were kind of for me, kind of not really my taste, but... but not that they weren't good boxes, just weren't good for me. But with Matt, he always seems to knock it out of the park for me. I've never gotten what I would call a bad box, even for me. Where I say, you know, it's for me, it doesn't really do it for me, but the value is there. His value is always there, and the books he sends are always just awesome to me. Anyway, he's got them sandwiched in between two pieces of cardboard with a little note that says, "Thank you. Start here. A weird one and end with a shiny one." Okay, a weird one. Oh no. First one out of the box. It says some weird S&M shit. Slasher. I can tell Foo influenced him now. Because, you know, the weird sexual deviancies that goes on at the Foo house is probably just, I don't even want to know. So I'm sure he influenced him here. But I don't know what number, three. Slasher number three. I like weird comics. I like the unusual. First full appearance of Artemis and Hephaestus. So if I read this and I contact mesothelioma, is there an 800 number I can call? Oh, this is cool. My girl on the cover. Avengers 281. All right, I'm digging that. PC book. All the way. Love it. And it is in excellent condition. That's also what I love. He doesn't put anything beat to hell in here. First appearance of Antithesis. Antithesis? Antithesis. It says it's got a... Well, he said this one has a $5 value. And this one, he says, has a $10 value. This is the Chadwick Boseman tribute cover. And this is Fantastic Four number 2. Antithesis. And I said it once. Antithesis. Antithesis. So, all right, he says it's got $10 value. As you know, you're not allowed to give values. Only I do that. And next up, no sticky notes on this, but dang, hello. Marvel Superheroes Spring Special, number 1, with Moon Knight. Of course, Moon Knight's popular right now. And this is the 90s, or early 90s. Yeah, 1990. Nice. Cool book. He didn't put a price on that one. We'll have to look it up. All right. And then we got first appearance in cameo of Baby Groot. Groot number 4. Cool. PC book. Definitely a PC book. He's got a $15 value on it. And this is first team appearance of the Stunticons. This is a Transformers book. This could be a Transformer book. It is a Transformers book. Transformers number 22. Also, excellent condition. The Stunticons? He said it's an $8 value. I'll hold on to it. I'm not a big Transformers collector, but I do have some. So, that are keys, and I'll keep that with them. First appearance of Amanda Waller and Brimstone, $12 value. I believe I have this one. I do. But I think this is an upgrade. For sure. So it's Legends number 1. I do have the first appearance of Amanda Waller. I don't know if it's a newsstand or not, but definitely a PC book. If I have two of them, I will sell one, the lesser value one off. Sorry. newsstand, hard to find, $15. Sorry, get choked. Oh, Wildcats, number 2. Not a fan of the Wildcats, honestly. Probably be a book that will go into the Whatnot auction someday, but still cool, $15 value. We shall see about that. Optioned Indie, Cover B, awesome read. That means I have it already then. What is it? Oh, maybe I don't. What is it? Tokyo Ghost, number 1. Huh. Remender, Murphy, and Hollingsworth. I've never heard of this, to be honest with you. Image. said $20 value. I'll give it a read and hold on to it. This has got a big black X on the back of it. And it says, first solo title. Oh, I haven't looked. First solo title? No, $10 value. Couldn't be, no. Oh, War Machine, number 1. Oh, duh. The foily, well, you know this is going PC. Foil goodness. Right there. You know it. I don't have it, so I'm going to PC. Gotta love it. He says $10 value. All right, now, curiouser and curiouser. We have this one. I have no idea what this is. It is Extras. Thanks for your patience. Again, he did not have to do that. Man, family always comes first, and you shouldn't have to apologize for that. People are that impatient, they can't wait a week. I mean, I'm an impatient person. I'll be honest with you. I mean, I give eBayers 5 days to ship my shit, and if they ain't shipped it, I'm on there. But when I know, and if somebody tells me in advance, hey, dude, something came up and I'm going to be a little late, I'm totally cool with that. It's a don't worry about it kind of thing. But anyway, we'll see what he threw in there. First up, oh, dude. I saw, man. And for that, you troll. After saying all these nice things about you, Matt, you troll me. You troll me and send me a Valiant book. Oh, Matt. Quantum and Woody number 3. Matt. Thank you for your patience. Here's a Valiant book. Man, Matt, I'm disappointed in you. Quit listening to Jedi Farce and all them. Foo had something to do with that. But he did send me another one. Dark Hawk number 25. Then it's some more of that foil. I'm gonna pretend you sent me this because it's foil and you know how much I like foil, and it slipped your mind that I know I'm not a Valiant guy. I'm the anti-Valiant guy. But anyway, there were extras thrown in unnecessarily so. But man, I'm gonna tell you what, all in all, straight up, fantastic box. Nearly every one of these books is going PC. Again, as of this recording, it's probably going to be another week, a little over a week before this video will come out. If he has any left, I'm going to buy another one right after this video. I'm hitting him up again. And I'm going to get him another one. So if he has any left, do yourself a favor. Jump on these. These are awesome. Oh, I ain't forgot. No, I know what you're thinking. You're going, oh, wait. Whoa. Don't start wrapping things up yet. You haven't run Matt through the eBay grinder yet. Of course I'm going to run him through the eBay grinder. Unnecessarily. Because he put all the crib notes on there already. And I already know I got more than $55 worth of value here. But we'll do it just for fun. And we will be back in a flash. All right, we are back. And we ran Matt over at Doghouse Comics through the eBay grinder. As a per usual. Okay, 55 shipped. Man, I'm gonna tell you, man. Well, let's just get the elephant out of the room here. First up, Wildcats number 2, the hard to find newsstand. He had a $15 value on it. Last sold was $4. In excellent condition, just like this one, $4. So, a little swing and a miss there, but that's okay. Hold on. Next up, Avengers 281 PC book, all the way. He had last sold, or he had a value of $5 on it. Last sold, nailed it, $5. And this weird S&M thing took me. No wonder he put a question mark on there as far as value. It's because you can't find it. I found the whole set of 5 for sale for $60. So I think it's fair to give it a $10 value by itself. $10. What the heck? Next up, Fantastic Four Antithesis. Now, finding this Chadwick Boseman variant was pretty difficult, but when I did find it, he had a $10 value on it, and about right at $10 for the Chadwick Boseman one. So yeah, hit it on the head. This one he didn't give any value to, and Marvel Superheroes Spring Special. Number one, last sold $5. I'll probably keep that one, to be honest with you. And next, Groot by Fabergé. Wait, that ain't it. Groot, number four, first cameo appearance of Baby Groot. He said $15. Right on the money. All right, here we go. Transformers, number 22. First appearance of the Stunticons. He had an $8 value on it. I don't know where you got $8 at, Matt. I really don't. But, you know, last sold on this thing was 20. Last sold on it was $20. Newsstand. So, yeah. $20. Last sold. Legends, number one. First appearance of Amanda Waller and Brimstone. Newsstand also. He had a $12 value on it. Once again, I don't know where he gets the price from, but last sold on it was $15. And this one was a little bit hard to find, so that's a good sign sometimes when you can't find very many of them. But this cover B, Tokyo Ghost number one, he said it's kind of all over the place, to be honest with you. There's a snipe in there that hit for like $8, but then there's one that hit for 30, and then there's, so it's all over. He gave it a $20 value. I'm going to split the difference. We'll say right around 15, so pretty close. And last but not least, War Machine number one, my foil goodness in mint condition. Last sold on this. He didn't have anything on it. Last sold $10. So just those, $55 shipped in, and those came out to $109. Now you want to throw in the extras that he gave me. Valiant, it's number, yeah, this Valiant book, it's a dollar bin book. All Valiant books are dollar bin books. But I did look it up before all y'all go, hey, you didn't even look it up, you just assume. I looked it up, it's a dollar bin book. Shocker, I know. But Dark Hawk number 25 is about a $3 book. So cool foil extras. So if you want to add those in, $113. So double. It's a double. It is a double all day long. And not only is it a double, but awesome books. Let's go with it. PC. 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 Yeah, I don't. I'll probably send this to Rude. This is up his alley. Some weird shit like that. PC. Definitely. Probably Whatnot. So out of all those, PC, Burn Barrel. So out of all the books he sent me, two of them are not going to go in, three of them are not going to go into my PC. That's fantastic. And I got, you're not going to get the bonus books if you buy from him. So 10 books. 10 books, 55 shipped. I'm on my way to Instagram now to order another one from him. So this channel is going to turn into the Doghouse Comics Unboxing channel. At the rate he's going. So am I happy with him? absolutely highly, highly recommend you pick up a Doghouse Comics box. That's why I run them through the eBay grinder. eBay grinder, don't lie. You can call me biased, whatever you want, as far as my taste goes. Just can't argue with facts, and that's why I do it. So go pick one up. I'm going to go put these all in my PC boxes. And then finish a big monster haul. You've seen it. It's already, that came out last week. But I'm still filming that big monster haul of books that I bought blind for $20. Halfway through them. God, I didn't realize there were so many of them. But that is going to do it for this one. Before you go, please do all those YouTube things that we like. Really helps the channel grow. It's, you know, seeing 50, 60 views and 4 likes is kind of, so help a brother out. Hit that like button. Only takes a second. Really helps grow the channel. But that's going to do it for me. We'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. Before I go, I want to give a quick heads up. After the filming of this video was finished, Matt posted that he had a little bit of a tragedy at his home. He fell victim of some flooding there in Missouri, and his basement flooded with about 5 inches of water. Unfortunately, he had about 12 short boxes and a couple long boxes of comics on the floor, and they were ruined. He's done an auction on Foo's channel to raise some money. He may have a couple of mystery boxes left as of today when this video is posted. So if he does, hit him up. Help support him. Help him raise some funds, because his renter's insurance did not cover flooding. And so he is out of pocket for not only his comics, but some furniture and some other things that were lost in the flood. So if you could head over to Instagram, show Matt some love. I think he's got books for sale still. Hit him up if you're looking for anything specific that he may have, and buy from him. Try to help him raise some funds and recover from this loss. Matt, my heart goes out to you and your family. It sucks when tragedies like this happen to good people. And this on the heels of, you know, I didn't ask you about your family emergency because it's none of my business. I figure if you wanted me to know, you'd tell me. But family emergencies are never a good thing. So this coming off the heels of that it's a sad thing when it seems like the world is just opened up and taking a big dump on you and nothing seems to go right. So if you guys can head over, I will drop a link to his Instagram as always in the description. Head over and check him out on Instagram. See if there's anything you can pick up from him. Pick up these mystery boxes. They're absolutely fantastic if he has any left. I think it's the last time I heard on this one he had like 5 or 6 left, so they're great value. So help him out, show him a little support, and let's support our community members. But that's gonna do it. So peace out.